Hey, good morning, everybody. Rick Sully. And I'll tell you what, it is such a beautiful morning, and I am so excited to be here with you. So much so that I'm standing up. And those of you who regularly watch my videos know that I'm a sitter. But today I had to stand up because you can't talk about lighting a fire under your ass if you're sitting down. All right, so here I am. Before I get into this, I want to talk a little bit about what we discussed the other day, about jump-starting your attitude, okay? A lot of us go through these little valleys, we go into these dark places, we can't get ourselves motivated. I gave you 5 tips that I use every time I get into one of those places. Number 1 was rest, 2 exercise, 3 visualization, 4 moderation, 5 persistence. If you try those 5 things, I guarantee you're going to see your attitude improve. But let me tell you something, and I don't want to rain on your parade at all, but improved attitude is only part of the equation, half the battle, all right? Because everybody's talking about making changes in their lives. I mean, I've been in sales for 20 plus years, and I'm always working with fellow salespeople that say, you know what, I want to be better. I want to work harder. I want to win President's Club. I want to make more money. Whatever it is, they're always talking about these changes, but then their actions aren't necessarily consistent with that. I mean, look at Facebook. This is a perfect example, and I'm not going to knock Facebook because it's been very good to me so far, but it's packed with folks who are talking about changes or improvements in their lives. Exercising, running, traveling, dieting, dating, you name it, it's out there on Facebook for everyone to see. But the question I have is, how often do those changes come to fruition? So if you truly want to take your game to the next level, or as I said earlier, light a fire under your ass, then it's got to start with 3 ingredients. It's got to be hard work. Can't argue with that. Nothing in this world is achieved without hard work. Second, you've got to have ambition. All right, you've got to want to do it. All right, it's easy to say, yeah, that sounds good. That'd be nice. But you have to really want to make it happen. And lastly is determination. Because there is going to be so many obstacles in your way. There's going to be other people telling you you can't do it. There's going to be your own self-doubts. You've got to be determined and committed to this, or else it's not going to happen. But again, I'm not pulling the rug out from under you, but these 3 ingredients alone are not going to get you where you want to go. All right? So I don't care if you're a stay-at-home mom. I don't care if you're an attorney. I don't care if you're a doctor, an entrepreneur, a network marketer, a sales professional like myself. If you want to change your life, I mean really change your life, then you've got to be willing to do the following 3 things. And this is where you've got to pay attention. This is where I take that match and I help you light it and put the fire underneath your proverbial bottom. All right? So pay attention. Number 1, refuse to be average. All right, we all know that we are capable of great things. At the very least, we're capable of better things than we're doing now. All right, but we become content in the life we're living. We're like, ah, it's good enough. I'm doing okay. I'm making a nice living. The kids are staying out of trouble. The house is nice. We'll have it paid off in 10 years. My business, my side hustle, it's doing okay. But is okay really what you want? Now, I very rarely get spiritual. I mean, hardly ever. I mean, you go back over all my talks, this may be the 3rd or 4th time that I've ever said God. But is that what God had in mind when we were created? Is that what he really wanted us, for us to be average? Because I don't think so. You know, I read an interesting quote the other day. I was talking about Michael Phelps. And Michael Phelps worked out 7 days a week, 365 days a year. And he said, I knew that by me working out on Sundays, that was giving me 52 extra days of working out than the competition. Think about that for a second. That, my friends, is refusing to be average. All right, so you've got to get desperate. You've got to never settle for less than your absolute best. You keep telling yourself you can do anything, and guess what? You're going to end up doing it. Number 2, get mad at yourself. Get pissed off. All right, don't allow yourself to fall into the same routine every single day. Get angry and use that anger to drive you. You guys saw my video on bullying. I had a lot of anger in my system, a lot of just burning inside of me. And I used that anger to drive me to become the person that I am today. All right, so you have to find that inside of you. And sometimes we can't. Sometimes just it's not our nature to get mad at ourselves. So what you need to do is you need to find some other motivation. Like, I'll show them. For example, if you lost your job or you got passed over for a promotion, whatever the case might be, use that to drive you. But it's still that anger and that frustration and the bitterness. Don't let it eat you up. Let it motivate you. All right? And the last thing I want you to do, if you really want to light a fire under your ass, is reward yourself. Okay, so let me finish my thought. Every Sunday night, every single one of us has this thought in our heads, all right? Tomorrow's a new week. Tomorrow is going to be great. This week is going to be amazing. I'm going to build my business. I'm going to get some great people into my network marketing group, or I'm going to make that big sale at my company, or I'm going to win my case, or I'm going to get all the things done around the house that I talked about getting done. But the fact of the matter, what starts to happen is the week goes on, you start losing steam. Things start stacking up against you. Your plans start to fall apart. And you don't get done what you need to get done. And you get frustrated. And guess what? You're back where you started. So here's what I'm going to suggest. Set a reward for yourself. I don't care what it is. But you got to set a challenging goal for yourself every week. Or every month. However you want to do it. And then what you do, all right, is you say, if I achieve this goal, I'm going to reward myself. I don't care if it's a night out. I don't care if it's a trip. Or buy yourself a gift. Did you have your eye on a new guitar, perhaps? Or a new set of golf clubs? Something around the house? A new purse? That's particularly my favorite. But, you know, it has to be different for everybody. But give yourself that reward. Because we're human beings, and we are going to run faster, and we are going to run harder if we have that carrot on that stick waiting for us out there. All right, so let's just recap. Number one, refuse to be average. Number two, get mad at yourself and use that anger to drive you to the next level. And last one, reward yourself for a job well done. I promise you guys, if you take these tips and utilize them right away, that fire will be lit under your ass. So be prepared, because there's no telling where you're going to go from here. I appreciate you joining me this morning for another Sully Says. I'd love for you to go to the iTunes website, download the Sully Says podcast, subscribe, leave a review. Anything you can do would be great. I also would encourage you to go to the YouTube channel and subscribe. You can get access to all my videos in one place. And lastly, if any of you need help lighting that fire under your ass, feel free to reach out to me via Facebook Messenger. I'd love to set up some time for us to talk about how we might be able to do some private coaching. So everyone, thank you so much for joining me on this glorious morning. And refuse to be average. Get mad at yourself and reward yourself. And get that fire started. Have a great Thursday, everyone. And we'll see you again soon.